On Now to Commitment 2010 tonight, and we're now hearing directly from 1st Congressional District candidate Frank Guinta about the so-called mystery bank account that has been raising questions for weeks. The account containing hundreds of thousands of dollars first surfaced this summer, and it's becoming an issue in the congressional campaign. WMUR's Josh McGelvin begins our coverage on this story.
That's right, Tom. Guinta actually came to News 9 this afternoon to try to settle this issue. It has really dogged him during the primary, and it continues to show signs of, well, not really letting up. Get a little bit of background here. During the campaign, Guinta lent and gave his campaign a combined $355,000. But according to his initial financial disclosure forms, he didn't really have that kind of money. He did amend the form in July to include an account or series of accounts that had assets between $250,000. But everyone is now asking, where did that money come from? And it is a violation of election laws to accept a large gift. For more on this, Guinta actually sat down with WMUR.com political director James Pindle. So, James, what did he have to say? What's the answer here?
Well, Josh, he didn't come with any new explanations or any bank statements, as he's been repeatedly asked to do. But he pledged that he earned every cent he gave his campaign and that he didn't receive the money from family or friends or anyone who wanted to buy influence. So with 20 days until Election Day, Frank Guinta is not just asking for your vote, he's also asking for your trust.
We were fortunate to be financially successful. We've made money in investments. We've made money in business. And it's not something that, you know, I always publicly talk about because I don't think that's really appropriate. I made a mistake. I acknowledge that voluntarily, immediately. And I also want people to know that, you know, my original disclosure form, you know, did show that, you know, I had the necessary resources to invest in this campaign. I understand that when you put your name on a ballot, there are those who will do nothing, stop at nothing, to tear you apart. I can handle that.
Well, it's clear that we won't learn any new facts, and we'll probably continue to be talking about this issue right through Election Day. We're in the process of posting our full interview for subscribers at WMURPoliticalScoop.com. Reporting live, I'm James Pindle, WMUR News 9.